Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to find an array whose sum, whose continuous sum is larger. Okay, so this is maximum sum array and we found a particular group of a subarray in this whose sum comes out as a maximum is 6. Okay, so it's like getting a maximum sum. So we will write a function maximum sum and it is taking array as an input. So what we will do is we will just let each a0 or a1 is initialized with 0, some initial arguments, let a2 which is array of 0, and we will just run a loop on to this array which is array dot for each we can do. Array dot for each, and it is a callback function which gives us two values, the iteration and index, I mean the item and index. So here we will try to get the maximum a1 which will hold the math dot max, math dot max of I, which is the current value of an array, and a1 plus I. Okay, once we get the maximum out of it, then we will just get the maximum of it for a2, which is again math dot max, and we will calculate maximum of a2 and a1. And once this is done, what we will do, return a2. So now if you try to do this with this simple array, what all steps we are performing? We got a1 and a2 just values. So a1 is 0 and a2 of 0, which is -2. Okay, now for every iteration we are just calculating the value of a1 and a2, and a2 will hold the max value. So I is the current index, which is I will start from 0 only, and a1 which is having the 0 plus I, which is -2. So math dot max will be for this, I mean I is -2 and a1 is currently 0, so -2 -2, a1 will be -2, and then a2 is math dot max of a2 which is initialized with -2. So in the first iteration we get -2, then in second iteration we got the second value 1, and here I is 1 and a1 plus I. So a1 initially we already have -2 +1 -1, a1 is -1, so now a2 will also become -1. Third iteration -3. So similarly we are trying to find the max of it and we are returning a2. So this can be pretty much straightforward. Other questions we can talk about is finding out the median of an array, right? So what we can do is median of an array, we will get a const median. Okay, we are getting an array, so we'll just put some base condition that array length should not be 0 and all these things, and it should be an array if the provided input is not an array. Array dot is array. In that case we will return null. If you can say array dot length, if this is equal to 0, then we will return null. Okay, so now we got the array, so we can actually create a clone array which will be array dot slice, which will give us the deep copy of an array, I mean just a copy of an array which we want, and we can actually sort this array. So we got the clone array. We can just do a sort operation on this, and it has a two argument a comma b, and we will return A minus B. Okay, now so we can get the mid of this array to find out the median. So math.floor and math.floor of here what we are doing is math.floor 0 and sorted array.length. So we got the sort.length minus 1 divided by 2. Okay. So this will give us the mid of the array. Okay. Here we will just check the sorted array. Let's call it a sort array. Little bit confusing. Here we are checking sort array dot length. I mean, is even or odd. If this is even, what we need to do is we just need to return sorted array of mid. Mid we have already calculated, plus sorted array of mid plus 1. This whole will be divided by 2, and we can return sorted array of mid. Okay, so if this is just a condition, if it is even, if the array length is even, then we have to actually get the median of like this. If this is odd, where modulus of 2 is not coming out equal to 0, that means we have like 5 elements. So third element will be the middle of it. We can get directly like this. Here we are just doing a sorting of the array just to get the array in the proper order. And here we are just checking even and odd. If this is odd, get the mid. Otherwise, just do this calculation. Sorted array of mid and mid plus 1, and just do the summation of it. Okay. And similarly, if you just try to get the second maximum of an array. So there are many questions. Array rotations, array reversal, return the nth maximum element from an array. You can do the sorting, searching, all these things. So consider you wanted to get the second max from an array, which should be pretty much simple, and you might have already done it. Second max, here we are passing an array as input, and what we need to do is let largest is minus 1 and let second as largest, which is second largest, is also minus 1. Okay, simple array dot for each we will do, and we will check if any element is greater than the largest. So here is the element, our callback. So here, if the element from an array is greater than largest, what we will do is, then that element will become largest. So we will get a temp. Temp will hold largest element, current largest element, and we will just put largest equal to temp, largest equal to the element. Okay, and the second largest will become, s largest, second largest will become the temp. This is the one, but consider that you have a condition else if element is greater than, not greater than largest, but element is greater than second largest. In that case, second largest will get assigned with that element. Simple. So this is how you will get a largest value and second largest value. Once the loop is done, you can actually return as largest, second largest a value. Okay, so we have done a lot of questions in these videos, like flattening of an object, flattening of an array, and all. Array flattening is also possible. You can call this recursively, but you can also check array dot prototype dot flatten. You can see there is already a method flatten, and you can just pass infinity also, I think. That means whatever your array is, like your array is something like this, 1, 2, right? It will give you the single array with all the values. This is called array flattening, same as the object flattening which we have done. Okay, in array, just to get the second largest, third largest, or searching, sorting, there are many questions can be on this. Like third largest, what will be your approach when you want to find out the third largest of an array, right? Either you can have these three variables, something like this, or you can find a particular proper solution of a particular this problem. Then we have a maximum subarray, which we have done in the current video, I think. Yeah, maximum subarray. Or you can also return the index. Okay, this is the subarray which will have the maximum sum starting from this index to that index, and related to string, like there is a string given to you. So in this you can largest length of a longest substring, right? So here he is the one, LL, there is a word repetition, WORLD, world is something which I can say where there is a no repetition of string, and this is the largest one. Okay, so just to get the start index, end index, and even the substring which is the largest. Okay, getting all permutation combinations of a string, that is also another important question. Is you have given a string, written all the permutations of this particular string, like ABC will have a ACB, ACB, ABC, CAB. What we will do in that particular case is we keep first character constant. Let's keep A in its position and keep swiping B and C. Then what we will do is let's keep B in its position and swipe A and C. Then finally, let's keep C in its position, then swipe A and B. We have already seen this. I will be writing the code also in the coming videos. Okay, thanks everyone.